say Selenium class 5 Java environment setup. This is practical chapter. So far we discussed three chapters in four classes. First one, introduction to Selenium. Second one, Selenium test process. Part of Selenium test process, not part, before Selenium test process, we discussed the software test process. Next, third one, yesterday we discussed overview of Java, Java for Selenium. Okay, next, Java environment setup and verify the environment. You know how to verify the Java environment? By write and execute a sample program, you can verify the Java environment. Okay?
Yes.
Come see. Fourth chapter in this program, Java environment setup. In this chapter, we are going to discuss two important topics. First one, Java environment setup. Just a minute. Java environment setup. Next, second one, Java syntax rules. Java syntax rules. Syntax means system grammar. We need to follow syntax rules for writing any type of computer program. Java syntax rules. First, Umadevi, why we need to set up Java environment? Why Java environment setup? What is the purpose of Java environment?
To execute the program from any directory
in
our system.
Any directory. Is it your description? What is any directory? That is environment variable. Don't mix the concepts. See, my question is, why Java environment setup? See, Java environment is required to write and execute Java programs, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
See, don't use that one, to execute or to access Java software from any directory. Java environment is required to write and execute Java programs. Say,
yes.
If you want to write any program, any computer program, editor required, editor.
Yes.
Suppose Notepad. Notepad is one editor. Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE one editor, and it has other facilities also. Editor required. Next, for compiling the program, compiler required. If we use Eclipse IDE, it has all required components for writing and executing programs. If you use Notepad, just save the file, then compile the file from command line prompt and execute the program from command line prompt. Okay.
Yes.
See, in order to write and execute Java programs, Java environment is required. Okay. Next, Java syntax rules. See, to write any computer program, if it is C or C++ or Java, any program, we need to follow the syntax rules. Getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Continue. First topic. Java environment setup. To write and execute Java programs, then Java environment is required. Okay. See, three steps in computer programming. One is, first step, write a program in an editor. Second step, compile the program. Third step, run the program. Write, compile and run. Three important steps in computer programming. If it is scripting like VB script, Perl, Python, etc., only two steps. Write a program in an editor and run the program. While running the program, it compiles automatically. It compiles automatically. Why? Scripting languages are lightweight languages. During execution, they compile and run.
They will compile automatically.
They compile and run. But in computer programming like C, C++, Java, etc., three important steps. Observe. Before that, Java environment setup. Java environment setup is required to write
and execute
Java programs. This is the purpose of environment. Next, suppose one small example, Vasavi. Suppose VB script is there. VB script. We use VB script in UFT, commutator of Selenium tool. UFT also for functional test automation. If you want to write and execute VB script programs, VB scripts, then you no need to have environment. Who is the vendor of VB script? Any idea?
No, sir.
Who is the vendor of VB script? Very simple. Divya Priya can answer it. Who is the vendor of Visual Basic Scripting Edition? Short form VB script.
Sir, I am not.
Keshav, who is the vendor of VB script?
I believe it's Microsoft.
Yes.
Sorry, sir.
Microsoft. See, yeah. In if you want to write and execute VB script programs from Windows operating environment, you no need to have any environment setup. Why? That VB script engine is built in Windows operating environment. VB script engine is built in. It is built in. See, just open Notepad, write VB script code. Just observe. See, open Notepad, write VB script code. Just a minute. Suppose dim A comma B, A equals to 100. Next, B equals to 200. Next, MSG box A plus B. Save as VBS file, not TXT. See, save as suppose file name add dot VBS, save. See, observe left side, VBS file created na. Click this file, it is showing output na, executing na.
Yes, sir.
A plus B is 300. Why? That VB script engine is an integrated that VB script engine is built-in component of Windows operating system. But Java is not like that. For writing and executing Java programs, you need to create a Java environment. You need to set up Java environment. Okay. See. Following Sanjita.
Yes, sir.
See, three important steps. Three important steps in computer programming. Say, my session is try to improve your programming skills, even though you are a tester. Why? In the IT industry, you can find programming everywhere. Take operating systems, Unix, shell scripting is there for Unix administration. In Windows also shell scripting is there. Take development, that is direct programming concept. Testing, in manual testing, no programming, but in automated testing, programming knowledge is required. Next, take databases. You take Oracle. In Oracle also, PLSQL is there, procedure language. There we apply control flow. So, in the IT industry, you can find this programming everywhere. Okay, development 100%. Remaining areas also programming is there. If you want to have long career in the IT industry, try to focus on programming. Okay, three important steps in computer programming. Okay, Umadeya will call you later. You come, Keshav. What are the three important steps? Tell me.
Write a program, compiler, and run the program.
See, three steps. I am asking first step.
Write a program.
In an editor.
Editor.
Earlier, I wrote program in notepad, VBScript. That notepad is editor in that scenario. Next, second step.
Compile the program.
Just a minute, I'm asking Keshav.
Yeah, compile the program. The last one
is. Compile the program. What is compilation, Keshav? Do you have any idea? What is compilation?
Well, I don't know exactly the definition, but seems like it is to... I know, but I can't explain.
Okay, cool. Divyapriya, what is compilation of program? Compilation.
Sir, compilation, like converting the...
Yes.
Programming language to machine language.
Not programming language. Converting the high level language into machine level language.
Okay, sir.
See, you take any program, we use high level language, English. English is high level for understanding computers. We use if, for, while, do. All are English words. Computer can't understand English words. Computer can understand binary language only, ones and zeros. See, compiler converts the high level language into machine level language. That is compilation. Okay, na Keshav? Any query raise?
No, sir.
Last step, Keshav, complete it. Write run the program, compile the program. Next.
Run the program.
Okay, good. Just a minute. Run the program. Next, Saida, we already discussed. If it is scripting language like Perl, Python, Ruby, etc., only two steps. What are the two steps?
I think write the program and run the program.
Yes, write a program in an editor and run the program. While execution, it compiles and run.
Yes, sir.
Lightweight languages. lightweight languages. Okay, you continue, Saida. Continue. See. Actually, we use Eclipse IDE for writing and executing our Selenium test scripts. You no need to have knowledge on writing programs in Notepad and compiling the programs using command line prompt. Just I will show that concept, that is basic concept, but that is not required for our Selenium testing. In our Selenium testing, we use Eclipse IDE only for writing and executing our Selenium test cases. Just basic, I will explain. See, steps for writing. Steps for writing and executing Java programs using command line prompt. It is not required for our Selenium testing. I am providing basic idea about programming command line interface. We use GUI. This is first one. Next, second one. Steps for writing and executing Java programs using Eclipse IDE. First one, command line interface. Second one, GUI using Eclipse IDE. Observe, Saida. First, I am taking this one. Some steps are common. Some steps are common. Okay. For this one, first, download Java software. Java is cross-platform. Download Java software. Here, what is the software name? JDK, Java Development Kit. It is full software. It includes JRE. JRE includes JVM. Why we are using JDK? We are going to develop and execute our test scripts. So development, test case development, also development, JDK, and install. Second step, set Java environment variable path in the OS environment. Set Java environment variable. That variable name also path variable in the OS environment. Now earlier Umadevi told. Now tell me, Umadevi, what is the purpose of Java environment variable?
We can execute the program from any directory from the
not only executing system. Compiling also. See, in order to access Java software from any directory, we need to set up Java environment variable. Suppose you installed Java in your machine in some directory. You wrote Java program on computer desktop. Java installed directory is different. Your program directory is different. If you directly execute it, it can't access Java. Suppose if you set Java environment variable, then Java can be accessed from any directory in your mission. Okay. Next, and one more thing, download Java software and install. We need to download, see, Java also open source, but vendor is there, vendor Oracle Corporation. You can download and install with free of cost. Say Java is cross platform. We need to download our operating system specific software, our operating system compatible software. If you want to use Linux, download Linux compatible Java. If you want to use Solaris, download Solaris compatible Java. If you want to use Windows, download Windows compatible Java. In Windows also, technical point of view, we have two types of operating systems, 32-bit, 64-bit. If you are using 32-bit OS, then download Windows 32-bit compatible Java. If you are using 64-bit Windows, then download Windows 64-bit compatible Java. Then you can use Java software. Following Asifa, any confusion?
No, sir.
Write a Java program in editor required, na? Suppose in Windows free editor is there, Notepad, and save with this double quotes only for understanding. Save with
java.java.
Save with Java extension. Yes. Java extension. Actually, Notepad default format is TXT, text file, but we are going to save as .java. Earlier we saved VB script file as .vbs. Okay. Next, fourth one. Compile the program file in command line prompt. And run means execution. See, these are the steps. Next, if it is Eclipse IDE, first I will explain the steps, then practical. Eclipse IDE, first step, second step, these two are common. Download Java software, download your operating system compatible Java software and install. Set Java environment variable in the OS environment. Next, third step, download Eclipse IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. Download Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE also open source. Remember, in our Selenium testing, we use all open source software. Selenium is open source. Eclipse IDE open source. Java open source, Python open source, TestNG open source, Maven open source, Jenkins open source. See, download Eclipse IDE and extract. No need to install Eclipse IDE. Just download you can get zip folder and extract. After extraction, you can get this Eclipse IDE folder. Open the folder. In this folder, you can find some subfolders and files. Here, you can find Eclipse Launcher file. Eclipse Launcher file. It is application. You click on this Eclipse Launcher file and you can launch Eclipse IDE. You can launch Eclipse IDE and work with Eclipse IDE. Just extraction, no installation concept. Okay, next. Write Java programs. What is the advantage of Eclipse IDE over Notepad editor? That we will discuss. Write Java programs in Eclipse IDE editor and run. These are the steps. Okay, now Saida, are you following? Any question? Raise question.
Yes, sir. I'm a little confused. So you explain all the steps for installing and installing the JDK and Eclipse, right, sir?
JDK and Eclipse. This is second one.
Second one. Step, right? Okay. Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay. Now you come. Vasavi, you come. Vasavi.
Yes, sir.
First I am taking first one. And I already told in Selenium testing, first one is not required. I am providing this concept for basic idea. It is basic in computer programming. But in Selenium testing, we use Eclipse IDE only. Okay? First, what is the first step? Download.
Download Java software, JDK and install.
Download Java. Here, JDK. Software. Here, our OS compatible. Our OS compatible software. Isn't it?
Yes.
See, it doesn't have common software for all operating environments. Operating system specific. Our OS compatible software. Okay?
Okay.
From either java.com. Java.com is previous vendor website, Sun Microsystems, or current vendor, Oracle.com. Oracle.com. Okay? Your operating system specific. Suppose mine is Windows 10. Windows 10, 64-bit OS. Okay? Notes I will provide. Observe. Launch Google search engine. See. Java 1.8, you download 1.8. Now 1.9 also available, but that is not stable version. Stable version is 1.8. Java 1.8 for Windows 64-bit. Windows 64-bit. See, observe Oracle.com. Observe second one, Vasavi. Java.com also there, na?
Yes.
This previous vendor, Java.com. Current vendor, Oracle. click this oracle.com. Observe na?
Yes.
Java SE 8. 8 means 1.8. Nowadays 9 also available. That is not stable version. So many issues with that version. So you try to use the stable version. Here observe. Different flavors, not flavors. OS compatible OS available. OS compatible software available. Linux 64, Mac 64, Solaris 64. See Windows x86, x86 for 32-bit. Windows 60 x64. It is for 64-bit. Our operating system specific software available na? Here first select license agreement. Next observe. Select your operating system compatible software. Suppose mine is Windows 64-bit. If it is Windows 7 or Windows 8 or Windows 10, same 64-bit, same. If it is 32-bit, first one, i586. Select this one, then it will download executable file. If you click this one, it will download executable file. Click, observe left side bottom, downloading, downloading. Simple download. Any problem, Vasavi?
No, sir.
I think I already downloaded. Okay. Second time downloaded. I already downloaded. Downloads. See, I already downloaded. See, JDK 8 Windows 64. I already downloaded. Again downloaded. Okay. Next, after download, just a minute. I already installed this one. I remove the installation. Observe Keshav, you also. I will remove the Java installation. And again, I will install. See how to remove, how to uninstall Java. Go to control panel. Uninstall a program. Here select Java. Observe Vasavi. Where is Java? Here. Java is there na? Uninstall.
Yes.
I already installed. I'm uninstalling this one. Just a minute. Yes. See, after Java software installation, we get Java folder in C program files. It is taking too much time. Just a minute.
Sir.
Tell me. Ask me.
Now we are uninstall the last one, no, sir. Earlier Java. Now we are installing new one. Na? The already existing projects are will be there or?
Already existing projects are there. No issue.
Okay.
No issue. You are just uninstalling and installing your Java, but your program files already saved on hard disk.
Okay, sir. Fine, sir.
Suppose Windows. Suppose MS Office is there, na? Suppose you created some 10 Word documents. After some time, you uninstalled your that MS Office old version. Now install new version. Then no issue with your existing documents. Na, the document saved on hard disk.
Yes.
No issue. Good question.
Okay.
No issue. if you already wrote and save some programs. They saved on hard disk, no issue. Yes. You can execute them with new version or newly installed version, suppose same version also, no issue.
Okay.
We are uninstalling only Java software, not programming content.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Just a minute. Over. Now install Java. Install Java. We downloaded na. Downloads. See, executable file. Just click this one. Click this one. Yes. Simple installation. Simple installation. Just wait. Taimish, are you following? Any confusion?
No, sir. I'm good.
Ah, see, preparing to install. Preparing to install Java SE development kit. See, after enabling next button, you click on next button. Now, next button not enabled. See, processing. Internally loading files. Just wait. Now, next button enabled. Click next. Next. See, it is installing. Copying new files. Just a minute. Any query, Umadevi? Ask me.
For now, no, sir.
And try to improve your interest on computer programming. Actually, so many feeling,
sir.
Computer programming is difficult, not difficult. If you enter into the programming, then it is very interesting. It's very interesting.
Yes, sir.
And your career will be improved with programming. Just a minute. Installing class data sharing. Sanjita, are you following?
Yes, sir. I'm following.
Okay. See. Okay. Observe Vasavi. It is asking installation folder. It is default one. C program files Java. If you want to use this default one, continue. Otherwise, you can change the folder. No need to change. Use default one only. See, 3 billion devices run Java. Just a minute. Simple installation only. No prerequisites required from Windows environment or Linux environment. You can easily install. Just a minute. Tangina.
Yes, sir.
Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Okay, try to attend regularly.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Already I told, after Java software installation, we get Java folder in C program files. Just a minute. See, close. Open my computer. Next, open C drive. Next, program files. Java. Observe, Keshav. Java folder available, na?
Yes.
Yeah.
And one more thing, Vasavi. If it is Windows 60, if you install Windows 64-bit operating system, then it supports 32-bit also. Getting this point?
Okay.
See, if you install Windows 32-bit, then it supports Windows 32-bit only. If you install Windows 64, it supports Windows 32-bit also. But suppose if you install Windows 32-bit compatible Java, you can work with Java, no issue. But that is not recommended. If it is 64-bit OS, you install 64-bit compatible software only. You may lose some files. So recommendation is use 64-bit compatible software only. Okay. Program files, Java is there. Next, go to command line prompt, CMD. Command line prompt. Okay. Where Java installed? Just a minute. Sorry. CD, change directory.
C drive.
Program files. What is the directory? Just a minute. Program files, space is there. CD, program files. See, are not case sensitive. DAS commands are not case sensitive. Next, CD, Java. CD, Java. Now we are in Java directory from command line prompt. Here observe Keshav. Just I am verifying the installation. Type Java, then it will provide Java software details. Providing na? Suppose if you don't install Java, if you type Java, Java is command. If you type Java, then it will show error. Now it is providing Java information. Suppose Javac, Java C. Java C means C for compiler. Then it will provide Java compiler information. Okay, not Taimesh?
Yes, sir.
First step over. Come to second step, Vasavi. Second step. Java, first step over. Downloaded Java software and installed, and I verify the installation also. If I type Java commands like Java or Java C, it is working. It is providing details. Next, second step.
Set Java environment variable in the operating
set
system environment.
Java environment variable. Variable in the OS environment, OS environment. We already discussed that one. In order to access Java's, now Java software available in C program files Java. If you write Java programs in the same directory, you can access directly. Suppose if you write Java programs in computer desktop, that is another directory. Java installation directory is different. Your program directory is different. That time accessing difficult. It's not possible. If you set environment variable, then you can access Java software from any directory in your machine. Machine means computer. I already set the environment variable. Once again, I will show that navigation. You can set Java environment variable in your machine easily. See, after the class, you try to set up Java in your machine. Tomorrow onwards, we need to practice Java programs. Okay? First, observe the prerequisites, Vasavi. Copy JDK bin directory path from your first observe, then you have to guide me from your computer. Next, observe the navigation. Select my computer or my PC, depends on your Windows version. My computer, and right click. Second one, select properties. Next, click environment variables. Next, before this one, just a minute. Click advanced system settings. Advanced system settings. Click environment variables. Next, select path variable. If already path variable is there, then select. Otherwise, you can create path variable, no issue. Select path variable in system variables pane. Pane means an area. See, observe, Vasavi, our environment variables two types. First one, user variables. Second one, system variables. You set path in system variables, then any user can access, na? Next.
Yes.
Click edit. Next, paste. You already copied, na? What is that one? JDK bin directory path. Paste bin directory path. Next, click OK. Next, Okay. Next. Again, okay. At the end, you can verify. Now guide me, Vasavi. Set Java environment variable path in this Windows 64-bit operating system. First, what is the first step?
Copy.
Copy Java bin. Copy JDK bin directory path from your computer. Okay. Open yes. My computer. Open C drive. Program Java. Files. Java. Open this Java. Here JDK, JRE available. Click JDK folder. Click this bin folder. This is bin directory. Now, copy this bin directory path from this address bar. Address bar. This is Windows Explorer, not Internet Explorer. Copy Java bin directory path from Windows Explorer address bar. Close. I copied. Next.
Select my computer.
Select my computer and right click.
Right clicks. And select properties.
Properties.
And click advanced system settings.
Advanced system settings.
And click and environment variables.
Environment variables. Yes. Observe, I already told na two types. See, first part, first half, user variables for admin. Second part, system variables. Select path variable from system variable.
System variable.
Path variable already available. Suppose if no path variable available, then no issue. You can create. Here new button is there na?
Yes.
You can create.
Yes, sir.
Already there. So I am editing this one. Edit. Edit.
Edit. Then paste in JDK bin directory path.
Paste. See. JDK bin directory path. I already. Then I am deleting this one. Okay. I pasted na. C program for yes. JDK bin. Okay. Click.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Next, close my computer. Or not? Next. Write a program in Notepad.
Java program in Notepad and save with Java extension.
Java. Save with Java extension. Okay. I'm creating new Notepad. Notepad. And one more thing, Taimish. You don't focus on this Java program. You don't focus. Later we will discuss. See, observe. I'm writing one small program. Public. Just a minute. Class. Class name, sample, open curly braces, close curly braces. Next, main method is required for executing the Java program. Public, static, what is public, what is static, what is void, we will discuss later. Void. Main, open parenthesis, string, open, square bracket, open and close, square brackets, args, close, parenthesis, open curly braces, close curly braces. See, this is the skeleton. Next, here you can write executable statements. Suppose I am writing one simple statement, system dot out dot println of means open bracket within double quotes, hello Java world. I am displaying one simple statement. Next, in Java, every statement should end with semicolon, that we will discuss in Java syntax rules. Next, save as
dot Java extension.
Dot Java extension. See, file, save as, sub, sample dot Java. Sample dot Java. Save. Close the editor. We can remove notepad. Observe our sample.java file. See, edit. Okay. Next, second step. Just a minute. It is first step. What is the first step? Write. Write a program in notepad. Notepad. What we wrote? See, edit. Don't focus on this program syntax. We'll discuss later. Second step. Compile the program. See, this is high level language. Class, sample, main, system, high level language. Convert the code into machine level language. Means compile the program. For compiling program, observe the navigation vasavi. Launch command prompt. See, we are discussing writing and executing Java programs in command line interface, but we are going to use GUI, graphical user interface, in our Selenium testing. Okay. After this one, we will discuss that GUI using Eclipse IDE. Launch command prompt. Next, change to Java program file directory. Java program file directory. Next, type javac, Java C, C for compiler, space. Next, file name. In our scenario, file name is sample dot Java. Then it will create Java bytecode class file dot class. Then it will create Java bytecode Vasavi. You can execute that class file from this Windows environment. You copy that bytecode to Linux or Mac and you can run. It is cross platform. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
This one. Compile the program. Guide me now. Guide me.
Launch command prompt.
Launch command prompt.
Save.
Next.
Java program file directory.
Our Java program file directory available in desktop, na?
Yes.
Desktop. Oh, just a minute. Where is the desktop? What is the path of desktop? See users desktop only, admin. that one only. Unnecessarily we users, admin, desktop. Okay, na?
Yes.
Now you can access your Java program file. But Java software installed in C program files Java. Getting?
Yes.
Our program file directory desktop. Our Java software directory C program files Java. But we set the environment variable. So we can access Java software from any directory. And now type Java command Java C. C for compiler. Java C. What is our file name?
Sample.java.
Sample.java. Enter. Error. Java 1. Error. Observe Divya Priya.
Yes, sir.
Any syntax error? Static void main args. Java C. Just a minute. Java C sample dot Java. Error. I think error in program. Edit public class sample. Public static void main. Observe Uma Devi, you also. Public static void main. String args. System dot out dot
println.
Any problem in this?
No, sir.
Public class sample. Okay. Oh, sample. C I used capital letter, na? C is Java keyword. All Java keywords are small letters.
Small letters.
Save. Save. See. DAS command. Clear screen. Okay. Java C sample dot Java now it is compiling. Compiled Vasavi. Okay, put mute Uma Devi. Vasavi, earlier what was the problem? What was the problem earlier?
Syntax error.
Syntax error. We used C capital letter for exactly. Class keyword, but all Java keywords are small letters, and Java is a case sensitive language. Now it compiled. How can you verify? After compilation, you can get Java class file, na? Means sample.java, that is program file. Next. Compiled code sample dot class. See dir. Now observe sample dot class created, na?
Yes.
You can copy this sample dot class file. It is byte code. You can execute this program. You can execute this one from any supported OS. Not only in Windows, Linux, Mac, Solaris, etc. Now execute here. థర్డ్ స్టెప్ కంపైలేషన్ ఓవర్ కంపైలేషన్ ఓవర్ థర్డ్ స్టెప్ రన్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్ రన్ ద ప్రోగ్రామ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో ఫస్ట్ టూ స్టెప్స్ కామన్ ఫస్ట్ టూ స్టెప్స్ కామన్ నెక్స్ట్ థర్డ్ స్టెప్ థర్డ్ స్టెప్స్ ఎర్లియర్ వీజుడ్ జావా సీనా నెక్స్ట్ టైప్ జావా క్లాస్ ఫైల్ నేమ్ వితౌట్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ టైప్ జావా క్లాస్ ఫైల్ క్లాస్ ఫైల్ నేమ్ వితౌట్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ దెన్ ఇట్ విల్ డిస్ప్లే ద అవుట్పుట్ ఇట్ విల్ డిస్ప్లే ద అవుట్పుట్ ఆన్ ద కన్సోల్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ కన్సోల్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎక్లిప్స్ ఐడి ఎక్లిప్స్ ఐడి కన్సోల్ ఓకే జస్ట్ ఎ మినిట్ టైప్
change to Java program file like
not required Java what is the file name
sample.java
sample.class but no extension required na what I told observe see here type Java command and what I mentioned
type java class file name without extension
is it okay
yes
what it is showing hello java world it is displaying the output na
yes sir yes
it is displaying the output now edit the program just a minute where is that one sample java edit now adding suppose just a minute hello software test engineers save close type java sample it is showing only hello java world okay you put mute Vasavi you come timeish it is
yes sir
it is not showing second output why See, we edit our program, but again compilation required, na?
Yes, sir.
Java C, sample dot Java compiled. Next, execute Java just file name sample this time it will provide two outputs observe two outputs hello java world hello software test engineers okay na
yes
now observe Saida we discussed writing and executing java programs from command line interface are you okay any confusion Anyhow, it is not part of our syllabus. It is only basic idea. Now confirm. Keshav, any query, raise query?
No, sir.
Okay, welcome. Continue, Taimish. Second one, Taimish. Steps for writing and executing Java programs using Eclipse IDE. Okay?
Yes.
For this, before going to download this one, I will explain. Okay, first download download Eclipse IDE. See, we have different flavors of Eclipse IDE, different flavors of Eclipse IDE, but you try to download Photon, that is latest one. See, Lona is there, so many other flavors are there, but you try to use Photon, it is latest one, compatible with all supported software. Remaining versions, some issues are there. Earlier I installed Lona is working fine, 95% worked fine, but when I try to integrate with Maven, some issues came. That's why I installed Photon. See, Eclipse IDE Photon, it is one flavor. Observe Saida, Photon for Java developers, na?
Yes, sir.
Java developers. See, Eclipse IDE packages. Observe. Here, operating system specific, there na, Windows 32-bit, Windows 64-bit, Mac, Linux, etc. Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You download your operating system compatible Eclipse IDE. Okay na?
Yes, sir.
I already downloaded. Observe. After download, you can get this zip folder. See, observe, Eclipse Photon zip folder. Then you can extract that one, extract files. I extracted to desktop. After that you can get this one. Click this Eclipse IDE, sorry, Eclipse application, Eclipse launcher file. Click this one. Put on some slow when it compares to other flavors like Luna, but it works perfectly. Now observe, I think earlier asked, who asked? Vasavi.
Yes, sir.
It is asking one path, na? See, users admin workspace. If you write any Java programs or Selenium test cases, they will be stored on this directory. Hello?
Okay, sir. Yes.
Suppose if you forget about Selenium test cases, that we'll discuss later. Now focus on Java. If you write any Java programs using Eclipse IDE, they will be stored in this directory workspace. Suppose after some time, if you uninstall your Java, no issue with your programming content. Workspace folder is there. In that folder, your programs are there. Again, you install new version of Java or same version of Java, you can execute. Launch. Did you identify, Vasavi? If you use Eclipse IDE, our Java programs will be saved in workspace directory in our computer.
Yes, sir.
Workspace directory. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Just a minute. I will provide brief introduction about it is launching. I will provide brief introduction about Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE. Observe Thaimish. All of you put mute except Thaimish. Eclipse IDE is a platform to write and execute computer programs. Not only Java Thaimish. We downloaded Eclipse IDE for Java developers, na?
Yes, sir.
We selected that one. But other compatible, other programs, compatible software also there. If you want to use Eclipse IDE for Perl, Python, Ruby, PHP, you can use it. Launched. Eclipse IDE launched. Leave it. See. Eclipse IDE is a platform to write and execute computer programs. Not only Java, it is not only for Java. We downloaded Java compatible Eclipse IDE. It is also for other programming languages. Programs like observe time is C, C++, next, Perl, Python, Java, Ruby, PHP, etc. Getting the purpose of Eclipse IDE?
Yes, sir.
It is a platform to write and execute computer programs like C, C++, Perl, Python, Ruby, Java and PHP. We downloaded Java compatible Eclipse IDE. Next point, Eclipse IDE. Eclipse IDE is an open source software. Anybody can download and use with free of cost. Then what is the advantage of Eclipse IDE? Earlier we used Notepad and command line prompt for compiling and executing the programs. Then what is the advantage of Eclipse? It provides editor. Earlier we used Notepad as editor. It provides editor for writing programs. Okay, Notepad also used for writing programs. Then what is the use of Eclipse IDE? It provides syntax guidance. Observe. Earlier we got one syntax error, but Notepad didn't locate that one. We manually identified that class we used is capital C, but here not like that. It can provide syntax guidance. Next, context help. And one more thing, auto compilation. Observe time is, if you use Eclipse IDE for writing programs, then just write program and execute. You no need to compile. Eclipse IDE is having auto compilation facility. isn't it?
Yes,
sir. Auto compilation. Auto compilation, etc. etc. What is that etc.? We will discuss later. See, if it is Notepad, if you want to integrate Selenium IDE, Selenium WebDriver with Java, TestNG with Selenium WebDriver, Maven with Selenium WebDriver, means integrating different softwares is not possible. If it is Eclipse IDE, you can integrate different softwares using Eclipse IDE and work with that software pack. Okay. Until then, just you remember this one. Now tell me, Thaimesh, what is Eclipse IDE? Three points we discussed. Tell me, what is Eclipse IDE?
Eclipse IDE is a platform to write and execute the program.
Computer programs?
Yes, computer program like C, C++, Perl, Python, Java.
Good.
It is an open source software.
Good.
And again, it provides the editor for writing and executing the programs.
Good.
It provides syntax guidance, context help, and auto compilation.
Good. Good. Okay, you put note for some time. Thaimesh. You come, Saida? Saida.
Yes, sir.
See, I will provide a navigation. Navigation, you observe. Later, you have to guide me. Navigation for writing and executing Java programs using Eclipse IDE. Observe the steps. First, launch Eclipse IDE. You know how to launch.
Yes, sir.
You open your extracted Eclipse IDE folder. In that folder, you can find Eclipse launcher file. Click on that Eclipse file, then it will launch. Next, create Java project. First, yesterday we discussed Java program hierarchy. First, create Java program. Java project. Next, create a Java package. See, under a project, you can create one or more Java packages. Okay?
Yes, sir.
One or more Java packages. Next, create a Java class. Under a package, you can create one or more Java class files. Create a Java class. Create a Java package. Okay. Note. Write Java code in the Java class file. See, these are the steps, Saida. Guide me. First, launch Eclipse IDE. We already launched. Just a minute. I'm closing this one. Open Eclipse IDE folder. Select this Eclipse application, Eclipse launcher. Now it is launching. It is showing a workspace. If you write any Java programs, these will be stored in this directory. You can change the directory. No, not required. Leave it. Launch. It will launch Eclipse IDE. It will launch Eclipse IDE. Just launched. Now, first create a, tell me.
Create a Java project.
Project. Observe the navigation. File menu. New. New. In some Eclipse IDE flavors, you can find Java project option. The Java project option directly. But here, Maven project is there. EJB project is there. JPA project is there. No Java project option. No problem. Here project is there, na?
Yes, sir.
You select project. Suppose in your Eclipse IDE, if direct Java project available, then you select that item. Otherwise, select project.
Yes, here, sir.
Type Java. Here Java project is there, na? Select,
right.
Select Java project. Select Java project. Project name. Suppose Selenium tests. Finish. Finish. Creating project. It is showing this one. Already created now. Okay. Next, continue, Saida. Java project created. Java project created. See one second.
Then create a package.
Just a minute. Just a minute. It is responding slowly. It is my machine issue only. I am deleting this project. Delete. Observe Vasavi. Here one option is showing, na? Suppose if you delete your project structure will be deleted. Suppose in that project some programs are there. If you want to delete your content also, here observe. Delete project contents on the disk. Okay.
Okay.
If you just delete project, content won't be deleted. I'm deleting content. Anyhow, it is blank project. Continue, Saida. File.
File. New.
New.
Create project.
Project. Here, select Java project. Okay. Project name. Suppose Selenium testing. Okay, click.
Finish.
Finish it now?
Yes, sir.
Next step. Create a project. Create a package.
Package.
Under the project. Select yes, project sir. And right click. New package.
Package.
Suppose package is ABCD. Finish. Next. Create a Java class. Create a Java class. Select package and right click new class. Suppose class is sample. Sample. Here you can generate main method. Main method is important component in Java program. Its main method starts from, program execution starts from main method. Generate main method for your program. Otherwise, you can type main method. You can type, no issue. Finish. Say, if you want to observe Saida, you want to,
yes,
if you want to configure Eclipse ID, observe here, window, preferences, general appearance, colors and fonts, suppose Java editor, edit, I used it, actually default is 10, I used it 18, suppose 10, okay, next, console font, console is debug, console font, edit, suppose 10, okay, apply, okay, now this is the default. Earlier I configured that one. Run.
Yes, sir.
Run. No need to compile. Run. Okay. Oh, we didn't write any code now.
No, we didn't write
any code. That's why no output.
Yeah.
Just a minute. First time it takes time for context help. See, context help. Otherwise you can type. Okay?
Yes.
Suppose hello Java world. Hello Java world. Run. It will provide the output on Eclipse IDE console. Observe. Hello Java world. Printed na?
Yes, sir.
Next, you add one more. You edit the program. Suppose
system dot.
See, observe. This is called context help. Out dot
print line.
Print ln of suppose hello selenium. Okay, I already told na, you no need to compile, just run, auto compilation happens. Now observe two outputs na.
Yes, sir.
And one more thing, configure once enough. Configure the Eclipse ID. I want to increase my font size. Window menu. Preferences. Colors and fonts. Under this colors and fonts. Observe. Select Java. Here. Java. Select Java editor. Edit. Default is 10. I want some 18. Okay. Apply. Next, I want to increase my console font also. Console font. Debug menu. Console font. Edit. Default 10. I want 18. Okay. Apply. Okay. Now increase it now. Now,
yes.
Run this program. Run. Hello Java world. Hello Selenium. Console font also increased. Now it is better.
Yes, sir.
Readable.
Yes.
Now observe Keshav. Are you following?
Yes.
See. Exit this one. This is about Java environment setup. Okay. I put mute for some time, Saida. You come. Divya Priya.
Yes, sir.
Java syntax rules. See, tomorrow we will discuss Java program structure with example. Next we will start Java concepts one by one, commands, data types, variables, operators, etc. First, Java syntax rules.
Java syntax rules.
See, first one, Java is a case-sensitive language. Java is a case-sensitive language. What is the meaning of case-sensitive language?
Like wherever we have to use small letter, we have to use small letter.
Okay.
Accordingly, like if you use capital instead of small, it will be a syntax error.
All case sensitive means difference is there between uppercase and lowercase values, isn't it?
Yeah.
Difference is there between uppercase and lowercase values. Suppose if you use uppercase for variable declaration, use same uppercase for remaining part of the code. Few small letter, it won't accept. So for example, VBScript is not a case sensitive language. In VBScript, no difference between uppercase and lowercase values, but Java is a case sensitive language. Difference is there between uppercase and lowercase values. C also case sensitive. Observe, all Java keywords, just a minute, all Java keywords, all Java keywords are small letters. Small letters. Example, okay. If for class, main
static
void etc.
Public
etc. All Java keywords are small letters. Java is case sensitive language. Next, first letter of class name should be in uppercase. See, first letter of class name should be uppercase. Uppercase. Observe, sample incorrect. Next, sample
correct.
Next, you can use two parses also. First, program, F capital, P capital, correct. Or first program, F only capital, it is also correct. First letter of class name should be uppercase. Next, third one, Java method names should start with lowercase. After first letter, you can use uppercase also, no problem. See, Java method names should start with lowercase value. This is third syntax rule. Next, I already discussed indirectly. Java program file name should exactly match with class name. I didn't discuss. Java program file name should exactly match with class name. Observe Divyapriya. Observe. Here I saved as sample.java.
Yeah.
Edit this one. What is the class name?
Sample.
I used the same file name na. Forget about extension. I used the same file name na.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Now tell me, you are trying to ask something.
Sir, here the class name should start with uppercase. Okay, yeah. So the Java program file name should exactly match with the class name. The program file name is something like which is nothing but the name which we are using to save the program.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Here I followed two syntax rules, na? Observe.
Yeah.
Edit. See, class file name started with uppercase.
Uppercase.
Next, class name sample. Next, file name also.
Program file
name. Sample. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Next one. Important one. Java program execution starts from main method, that is built-in method of Java. Java program execution starts from main method, and which is mandatory in every Java program. Otherwise, program won't be executed. See, Java program execution starts from, earlier we executed VB script, na? In VB script no such formalities, that is a lightweight language. See, starts from, don't use double quotes, it is only for identification. Main method and which is mandatory for every Java program. It is built-in method. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Next, sixth one. Observe Keshav, you also. Every Java statement, or you can say step, or you can say instruction. Every Java statement should end with semicolon. Should end with semicolon. See, this is the symbol. Suppose VB script. In VB script, no such formalities. You can write plain statements. Plain statement. Are you following, Vasavi? Any confusion, ask me?
No, sir. Clear.
Okay, good. Next, code blocks. Java code blocks. See, suppose system.out.println, that is a normal statement. Every Java normal statement should end with semicolon. Next, Java code blocks are like conditions, condition block, if condition block, condition block. Next, loop block,
loop.
Method block, method, etc. Java code blocks enclosed with curly braces. Enclosed with curly braces. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Next, 8th one. Java supports explicit declaration of data types. See, Java supports explicit.
Explicit. Yeah, yesterday we discussed.
Explicit declaration of first data types, then variables, data variables. Types. Observe, I'll provide one example. In Java, see, int SNO, SNO is variable name. Int is data type equals to 1, 2, 3. This is correct. Suppose int x, it is also correct. We didn't assign any value. Later you can assign. Next, char a equals to single quote d. Semicolon. Char is data type. Small a is variable name. Capital D is value. Suppose boolean y equals to true. True is Java reserved word. Boolean is data type. Y is boolean variable name. True is value. Suppose if you write like this, b equals to 100, this is incorrect. This is incorrect. Why? No data type. See, in Java programming, explicit declaration of data types. Observe, if it is VB script. VB script, no data type concept. Observe, dim city. No semicolon, like formalities in VB script. Now tell me, Divyapriya, what is that city variable? What type of variable? No data type. It is variant. In VB script, only data type is variant. Variant means it varies. Variant means it varies. No data type. No explicit data type in VB script. Here only data type is variant. Means it varies. How it consider data type? Based on usage of the data. Suppose if you enter city equals to 100. City equals to 100. Then internally it considers the data as integer data. Suppose if you enter city equals to 12.34. Then internally it considers the data as double type data. Suppose if you enter city equals to within double quotes India, then internally it considers the data as string type data. String type data. Suppose if you enter city equals to hash quotes 10/10/2010, then internally it considers the data as date type data. But
yeah,
not like that. Suppose you declared int x, na integer, integer, suppose x equals to 1, 2, 3, it will accept. Suppose after some time, if you use x equals to a, b, c, d, this is incorrect. Getting the point?
Yeah, yes, sir.
In
because
Java,
we declared as integer and giving
yes, in Java, explicit declaration of data types. Next, observe the ninth one. Java supports explicit declaration of variables. Don't confuse. Earlier data types, this time variables. Both are combined, but difference is there. Java supports explicit declaration of variables, but VB script supports both implicit and explicit declaration, but yeah. Best practice is explicit only in VB script also, but VB script supports implicit and explicit declaration. Observe both. Both in Java suppose int a comma b, you can declare multiple variables in a statement by separating with the commas. Okay, suppose first I declared variables, later I am initializing the values, or you can initialize the value while declaration also. That we will discuss in variables chapter. B equals to 20. Okay, correct. Suppose C equals to 30. Observe this last one. It is incorrect, na?
Yeah, because we did not declare.
We did not declare that one. Suppose in VB script, it supports implicit and explicit declaration. Observe dim, using dimension keyword, we declare variables in VB script. Suppose dim a, no semicolon like formalities in VB script, plain statements. Dim a equals to 100. Next, b equals to 200. No error. See, we declared A only, but we are using B also. No problem. You can use. A is explicit variable, already declared. B is implicit variable, means we are directly using that one. Yes, you can use. Suppose MSG box A plus B. Comment symbol is single quote. It will show 300, no issue. See, it is also correct. It is implicit variable. Did you understand this concept? Tangina, did you understand this concept?
Yes, sir.
Java supports explicit declaration of variables, whereas VB script supports continue tangina.
Implicit and explicit both.
Yes. VB script supports implicit and explicit declaration of variables. Here explicit declaration means first declare the variable, then use it. Implicit means directly use variable. Directly use means without declaration. Now, end of the day, you put mute Divyapriya. Tangina.
Yes, sir.
Java syntax rules. We discussed 9 syntax rules. What are they? Just tell me the headlines. First one. Java class. First, Java is a case sensitive language.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? That is first
one. Java is a case sensitive language.
All Java keywords are small letters. There is a difference between uppercase and lowercase values in Java. Why? It is case sensitive. If it is VBScript, VBScript is not a case sensitive language. There is no difference between uppercase and lowercase values. Second one, continue.
First letter, class name, first letter of the class name should be start in upper letter.
Good. Third one.
Java method names should start with the lowercase.
Good. Fourth one.
Java program file name should exactly match with the class name.
Good.
And Java program execution starts from main method.
Which is mandatory in
Java
every Java program. Next, continue. Sixth one.
Every statement should end with the semicolon.
Every statement or step should end with the semicolon. Next.
Code blocks like conditional, loop, method, etc.
Conditional or loop or method enclosed with
curly braces.
Curly braces. Next.
Java supports explicit declaration of data types.
Good. Next.
Java supports explicit declarations of variable.
Good. Good. See, today I am going to close the session, Asifa. Today we discussed two topics. One is Java environment setup. Another is Java syntax rules. Tomorrow we'll start coding. Confirm, Asifa. Any queries?
No, sir. I'm good.
Welcome. Divya Priya, any queries regarding this today's class?
No, sir. I'm good.
Welcome. Keshav, Rise Pari?
No, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Welcome. Saida?
No, sir. I'm good. Thank you.
Welcome. Sanjida?
I'm good, sir.
Welcome. Thaimish?
I'm good, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Tanzina.
I'm fine, sir. Thank you.
Welcome. Yuma Devi.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Can
we directly download and extract the Photon, Eclipse Photon, or do we need to do anything for the existing one, Luna?
Existing Luna is there in your computer?
Yes, sir.
You just delete that one.
Okay.
You just delete that one. Suppose if you have Eclipse flavor already, Luna or something.
Yes.
No installation concept, yes, na. So just delete that one. Observe here. Here on my desktop, Eclipse is there, na. Delete this folder.
Yes, sir.
Delete this folder. Next, download new flavor of Eclipse ID and extract, you can work. No complication.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Any other queries?
No, sir.
Okay, welcome. Vasavi, Rise query regarding
no
this
query.
Class? Okay.
No queries, sir.
Okay.
Clear, sir.
Okay, welcome. We will meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.